idea of my project is that how can we communicate to each other for free, because in China and in country, the way that we communicate by phone is by using a service provider, for example, like AS and DChat in China. And because of when the service provider gives us signal, the signal must be broadcast by the radio tower or the satellite. So that's the reason why it costs money. So that is my idea. So how do we communicate to each other for free? And I've got this one idea. It is called mesh network. So with a mesh network enabled device, the other people can communicate to each other for free, because the ship itself can broadcast signal and receive signal itself. So if you have two mesh enabled devices together, the first one will broadcast the signal to the second one, and the second one can receive the signal from the first one and then broadcast it again. So my concept with that is that if the whole country uses a mesh enabled device or mesh enabled phone, the whole country can have like a big giant network that is a mesh network that can communicate each other for free in this big giant network. So after that, I started to research about what can I do to create this work. So then I've got this idea, this bot. It is called the Raspberry Pi. So by using this bot is a very flexible one. You can do like almost everything. And this bot is Linux-based. Linux is just one kind of operating system like Windows and Mac OS. And many people have used this bot for many projects, so I start to look it up about it and then buy it and use it. And then I started to research about how can this device be related to mesh network. So then I got a chip called FP, it is this one. This chip can transmit and receive mesh network, but then I encountered a problem with it, because when I'm trying to use this XP chip, the language is very complicated. For example, Raspberry Pi is the programming language called Java, and sorry, called Python. Yeah, and you can use Java too. So, and by that, Java and Python are the example of the language that is easy to communicate when comparing to other languages. But this one is actually hard, so that's a problem. And by learning this, it takes a really long time. So, and I don't have time to learn it, because it may take more than a semester to learn. So then I changed my idea about it. So when I'm doing my final product, I'm trying to create these devices that can communicate to each other, like two bots can communicate to each other. So then I found this point and on this Raspberry Pi. So we have two Raspberry Pis here, and it is connected to this router. So I use the command called netcat to make these two Raspberry Pi communicate together, like we can send text messages to each other. So this is the example. So the command netcat is a very simple command. So the first device, the first Raspberry Pi, must have a command called netcat. But it is a different command than the second one, because the first Raspberry Pi has to write a command that the command will listen for the other nearby device that is in this within this router to find, like want to listen to. And then the second device must type the IP address of this device in order to connect this device to this device together. So I'll show the example of when this connected. So like when I type the word hello here, it will show up on here too. And when I type something like hi, then it can show up to this device too. So that means that two devices can communicate together. Yeah. And so for my mesh work project, I hope that I will continue this project to next semester and make it Τώρα.